Brendan Fraser has become one of the best actors in recent years. His last two films were very well received, and he even landed an Oscar win for his lead role in The Whale. In the 2000s, Brendan was just as popular, with movies like The Mummy and its sequel The Mummy Returns, and dramatic films like Crash. I remember watching a lot of Brendan Fraser's movies and enjoying them, whether it was Blast from the Past or Encino Man. I seem to remember a lot of them being pretty good. But Brendan Fraser has also been a part of some not-so-stellar movies. In fact, if you look at his reviews, only a third of his films are well-received. Out of the 34 featured films he's been a part of, only 9 of them rank above 60% on Rotten Tomatoes. Now, I know movie reviews and rankings don't always mean everything, especially when it comes to Rotten Tomatoes. But even with the reviews aside, Brendan Fraser has been a part of not only one, but 2 box office flops. His first was Dudley Do Right, a slapstick comedy based on the cartoon by Jay Ward, the same person who created George of the Jungle. The George of the Jungle movie had been a huge success, so they took another chance on this IP. It starred Brendan as Dudley, Sarah Jessica Parker as the love interest, and Alfred Molina before he was Doc Ock. The film was a flop from opening weekend, bringing in only $3 million of its $22 million budget, and grossed less than $10 million during its run. And yeah, what do you expect? It's a Dudley Do-Right film. But to put this in better perspective, George of the Jungle, which came out 2 years before, cost $55 million to make, and they grossed over $174 million. As to why it was such a big flop, the movie itself was bad and the studio knew it, choosing to release it at the end of summer. And compared to The Mummy released earlier that year, cartoony slapstick comedies just could not compete to the blockbuster movies that were coming out. The reviews came in and it was dead in the water. Because of The Mummy's success that year, most people overlook this film and it gets forgotten about. Similar to his other flop, Monkeybone. Brendan Fraser called this movie, at the time, the most expensive art house film 20th Century Fox has ever done, and he was not kidding. This film had a lot going on. It's directed by Henry Selick, the same person behind Nightmare Before Christmas and later Coraline. The film uses a lot of different techniques, including stop motion with live action, practical effects mixed with CGI, and also robotics and puppeteers running some of the monster effects. A lot of this footage comes from the behind-the-scenes features off the DVD, and you can see this film does have a lot of creative ideas, and all of the robots and puppets are great. You can tell a lot of love and care went into making this film. It does have a lot of creativity, and you see it in the scenes downtown, and some of the shots even do a great job at capturing that Tim Burton-era funk. The cast is also pretty well stacked, with John Turturro voicing Monkeybone, Rose McGowan as a cat, and sketch comedy stars from SNL, Mad TV, Kids in the Hall, and even Mr. Show. This movie had both Saul Goodman and Gus from Breaking Bad. Gus plays a cockroach and has to walk around on his knees the whole time. People who have seen this movie joke that this is Chris Kattan's best movie, and it is. Since he is on the cover, you think he's gotta be in the movie a lot, right? Wrong. He's only in the movie in the later half, where he plays a deceased gymnast and his dead body is used as a vessel for Brendan Fraser to get his wife back. Trust me, that sounds a lot cooler than it really is, but it still wasn't enough. This film has a lot of cool things going on, but the film itself feels like it has no identity. During filming, the studio would want change after change until the final product was a mess of ideas jumping from raunchy sex comedy to dark gothic imagery. Similar to Dudley Do-Right, the studio had no faith in the final product. They did little to no promotion for this film, and because of it, it bombed, making only $7.6 million of its $75 million budget. But once again, is this because of Brendan Fraser and his acting abilities? No. His only fault is choosing to do these movies, and he knows that, something he has talked about now, saying he is more careful with what films he does. And it seems like he's been sticking to that, with his next film being Killers of the Flower Moon, directed by Martin Scorsese, where he will join fellow Oscar winners Leonardo DiCaprio and Robert De Niro. Brendan Fraser is a great actor. He can be very broad and diverse. Even during these flops, Brendan still went on and acted in Oscar-nominated movies and summer blockbusters. His strength and resilience in this industry is a true testament to his character. Whether he's playing a caveman or a cyborg, he is convincing. He can do action, comedy, and drama all in the same film if he really wanted to. Brendan Fraser has been through a lot, and he brings that pain and power with him when he comes to the screen. Even after having a flop or two, he was still able to find a way to keep going. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time, I'll see you on the internet.